Okay, this is my second drive-in theater box. Thank you to Phil for making this for me. We were going to record a video at the drive-in, but we ended up just enjoying it so much we forgot to do it. So this is the video I'm making for Phil. This is my drive-in theater box. Sounds amazing, amazing, amazing sound. I have one speaker over there, the right channel. There's that again. There is the left channel. I have the subwoofer over there and it's pointed. I put the subwoofer right by my chair. I want to hear the bass. But this thing sounds incredible. So a quick overview. This is our right channel for the right speaker. This is for the left speaker. This is for the subwoofer. Up here, this is actually, you can use this as a power station. It has USB-C, Type-C, and quick charge. It charges through an Anderson power pole. And I do have a solar panel that I'm going to be charging it. So this system is going to be totally solar. So I plan on charging it all the time with the sun. This has 1, 2, 3. I keep the tape on there because it won't stay down. I have 3 12-volt cigarette lighter plugs, which is going to be perfect because I plan on using this to run a 12-volt refrigerator freezer for camping. Oh, and here is the stereo unit. This sounds amazing. My old unit that Phil made sounded great with the radio, the Bluetooth, and it wasn't his wiring, it wasn't what he did. It was just the quality of the marine radio that I was using. The Bluetooth did not come in that good, but on this, it just sounds fantastic. I have the radio on now. This is what the radio station is playing at the drive-in, but the sound is just so amazing on this. I can't get over how good it sounds. And this is pretty cool. It came with this little cover that goes on there. And this cooler is basically waterproof. So I have here is where the FM plug is. He has it put under the handle, which is kind of good, so it's hidden. All right, so let me open up so we can see the guts. Oh yeah, look at that. This is the backside of the marine radio. The specific reason I bought this kind, it had good reviews for sound, but I knew I was gonna be at a premium for space. So there's really not much more space, not much more that can get in here. So this one was very narrow. It's not that big, so that's why I picked that head unit. Because the reviews said it sounded good, but I wanted something small. If I would have gotten a full stereo, that would have been sticking in and would never have fit in here. So let's look down here. This is the amplifier right here. Now I had an older amplifier in my old system like this, but it was like half of this. So this is basically double. I had a different amplifier that was really good sounding, but the sound bled through. And what I mean is left and right channel would bleed into the subwoofer, and it made it sound great, but it just at times the subwoofer couldn't handle it and it would make like a screeching sound. So I knew I needed to get another amplifier, and this amplifier, it just sounds good. There's no bleeding. It's only the deep low bass that goes to the sub. Let me just get a good quick view of everything in here. And even this is like the connection board for the amplifier. It's got the, you can control volume, treble, bass. I think this is bass. Yeah, that's the bass. That definitely controls that. Yep, this is, God, this thing just sounds great. I love it, love it, love it. And I even did this, I never hooked up the auxiliary, the RCA, but he left it in here, so I got this little adapter. Let me get that out of there. How'd that get in? Hold on. Okay. So I got this little adapter so I could just plug a auxiliary 3.5 millimeter plug into it. So I would just have to lift it up, but I don't really use this for auxiliary. The Bluetooth on this sounds fantastic. And this is just a quick, the only drills he had to do was drilling the stereo in here, putting the power board here for the 12 volt, putting this here for our plugs, and putting the radio on the side. Everything else is totally intact on this. There's no other drills. I'll tell you, this thing sounds amazing. Here's what it turned on. And you could see the voltage meter showing the voltage. I know when you record that, it looks like it's flipping on the camera. It's not doing that now. It's when the camera's not looking at it, it's not doing that flickering. Okay, so this is going to be night two of April Ghouls at the Riverside Drive-In. Thank goodness the weather improved. It got down to about 37 degrees, 36 degrees last night. It was cold. It's only supposed to get down to 51 tonight. This is going to be packed. Once everyone gets set up, everyone's going to be set up in the front row. Phil, this is what you wanted to see. I'm going to try to record later, but everyone's going to be sitting out here. Everyone is going to listen to your creation, Phil. So thank you, Phil, for this awesome system. I love it, love it, love it. I will be on my worldwide tour going to different drive-ins. I've been to Texas already this year, last one with Phil. I'm in Pennsylvania today. I'm going to be back in Pennsylvania in a month. Okay. I'm signing off. This is awesome. Thank you.